I have to say that I really didn't plan to study fashion. My mother was more of a fashion person, and she used to have this flair from when she was very, very little. In fact, it came from my grandmother, who used to be a weaver of cloth. And my mother was very stylish all the way from her, I think, high school till university and beyond. She started to make her own clothing and stuff. So she had that flair. So I grew up surrounded by my mother making clothes and things. And I used to wonder, why is she wasting her time? Why can't she just go to the store and just get something to wear? Especially when she now had this little shop by the side, and she had tailors. And she would complain to me endlessly and say, these tailors, they're not good enough, they didn't come today, they didn't do this well, the condition is not good. And I just thought, the more reason why you should just go to a Selfridges or a Harrods or something and buy what you want to buy and wear. So anyway, as I went along with her, I did not know that subconsciously fashion had started to sort of soak in. So when I went to school in America, by this time I had started to have a sense of style. I would say that I was an it girl in terms of dressing. I dressed very, very, very stylishly. And my favorite designer at that time was Betty O. Yes, she was a very good friend of mine. And then I would go to her to buy clothes, and I would take those clothes from Nigeria to University of Miami where I used to study. And I noticed that the Americans loved what I used to wear, because they thought, wow, this is fantastic. Where is it from? And I would say, it's from Nigeria. I would be wearing a duet mixed with denim, and I'd be wearing Ankara, and I'd be wearing African fabrics that are very westernized. So it was from there that I think that fashion started to really, really sit upon me. At that time, Africans did not express themselves much because it was not cool to be African. It wasn't cool to sound African, and it wasn't cool to dress African. But by the time that I showed up this fashion in school, I started to realize that, wow, there's a lot that we can do with fashion, and that the whole world can actually find value in what we're doing and actually buy it, so we could actually start to export. For me, philosophically, I have always wanted to empower our people, and I've always wanted to empower women, African women in particular, because I know that there's a lot of potential to us, and there's a lot that we can do in terms of skilled craftsmanship and even more. So I came back with this whole thing in my mind, but it hadn't come together yet. My mother had a problem with her tailors, and she said, look, come in here and come and help me manage them for a bit. So I was thinking that I was going to be there to practice my managerial skills, because I just got a first degree in business administration. But when I got in there, she didn't have a designer who would make men's clothing. In those days, she started with Agbada and different captains, menswear that were contemporized. So what I came in to do sort of expanded, because I was managing the tailors, but then I started to see that, wow, I could design this, I could draw this, I could, you know, I was quite good at art anyway, before I had to be forced to drop it from 3 in Queen's College to take economics, because I had to do what mommy and daddy wanted me to do, you know. So I got in there and I started to draw, and it came very, very natural to me. So I actually started doing men's clothing, not even ladies' clothing, yes. So because what I used to do for the Agbada, for the embroidery, was that I contemporized the embroidery. Instead of having the large, huge designs on the front of the Agbada, I would do a lot of what I would say wearable, what I would call wearable art. So this is how I started.